from Adventist World Radio in Pune.
A warm welcome to you as you join us.
This is our International English Service.
Today on our broadcast, we have music coming to you from heritage singers and Jody and Loni Malashenko.
A health message on asthma.
Followed by a story for children entitled, 1 out of 10.
Ending our program with a message from God's Word on the topic, Walking with God. I'm Anita.
I'm Sharad.
And you're listening to Adventist World Radio, the voice of hope.
Let's begin our program with a song, Come Along With Me.
Come along with me to a land called paradise. Come along with me to a land called love. To a land that's free.
Listening to a song by heritage singers on Adventist World Radio. And now we invite Dr. Kisko to share a health message on asthma.
Hello, I am Dr. Kisko, a chest specialist from Pondicherry. Today I would like to talk about asthma, bronchial asthma as it is commonly known. Asthma is a very complex disease that affects the lung. It is a chronic illness that causes breathing difficulty, cough, and if it is left uncontrolled, it can cause degeneration of the lung. Acute attacks of asthma many times can be fatal. I have seen quite a few patients come with acute attacks and succumb right in front of us. On May 3rd, 2005, we celebrated the World Asthma Day. And the theme chosen for this year was the unmet needs of asthma. Now, this initiative has been taken by the World Health Organization to spread the awareness of asthma among public. Now, it is estimated that there are around 20 million people in India suffering from asthma. But unfortunately, around 14 million people, that is 75% of asthmatics, are not getting the right treatment. This is because of lack of awareness and certain myths and superstitions that surround this disease. Now, asthma is an allergic disease that is caused by a combination of genetic and environmental factors. Rising pollution levels is one of the main reasons for the increasing number of asthmatics in cities and towns. Asthma can develop at any age, affecting children and adults alike. The symptoms of asthma may differ from person to person. Cough and wheezing and chest tightness are some of the most common symptoms, especially on exposure to certain allergic substances like dust, smoke, and certain strong smells. These symptoms can also get precipitated with exercise and physical activity and change in climatic conditions, and also because of seasonal changes. Frequent cold and cough that go to the chest and take more than 10 days to go is also one of the common manifestations of this disease. People who have chronic asthma are usually coughing and wheezing all the time. They are short of breath and cannot even walk a few steps. The problems that occur with untreated and or uncontrolled asthma are many. It can cause growth retardation in children and also growth retardation of the babies in pregnant mothers. It is the most common cause of school and work absenteeism. Acute severe attacks of asthma can be fatal, and chronic uncontrolled asthma can cause degeneration of the lung, causing respiratory failure and severe physical disability and eventually death. But the good news is that all the problems of asthma and complications of asthma is completely preventable. Now, asthma may not be curable, but can be controlled very well. People suffering from asthma no longer need to suffer, and they can lead a normal to near normal lives without getting their day-to-day activities affected. And what has brought this change or revolution in the treatment of asthma is inhalation therapy. Inhalation therapy is nothing but breathing in the medicine into your lungs. And this is possible to control asthma close to 100%. But the acceptance of inhalation therapy among the public is still very poor because of certain myths and superstitions that surround inhalation treatment. People think inhalation treatment is very strong, very addictive, and is to be used only as a last resort in asthma. But actually, inhalation treatment is absolutely safe. Inhalation uses a very small dose of medicine and is not addictive at all. It is now recommended as the first line of treatment in asthma. In fact, compared to oral medicines or injections, inhalers contain only 1/10 of the dose, and thus it is more effective than oral medicines and injections. A wide variety of inhalers are now available in the market, and an asthmatic patient can choose any inhaler that suits him the best. Another misconception regarding asthma treatment is the use of steroids. Yes, steroids are required for the control of asthma, but steroids used in inhalers is very, very small, the dose that is used, and it goes directly to the lungs and takes effect immediately, causing no systemic side effects. In conclusion, I would like to stress only 3 points regarding asthma. Asthma is a chronic illness. It cannot be cured, but it can be controlled perfectly, and a person with asthma can lead a perfect, normal life. Inhalers are absolutely safe and is the first choice to treat asthma. The third point, steroids used in inhalers are very, very low dose, very effective to control asthma, and does not cause any side effects. Many asthma patients have discovered freedom from life with inhalation therapy, but many more are still living and suffering with the disease. And this unmet needs of asthma can be fulfilled only if we shake the myths and adopt the facts. If you have asthma, please ask your doctor about inhalation therapy. Thank you.
Dr. Kisku, thank you for joining us on our program today. And now following a story for children told by our friend Sarah, entitled 1 out of 10.
Hello friends. How many of us stop to thank someone when they do something for us? Well, today's story entitled 1 out of 10 teaches us to be grateful. It was like a terrible dream in which you are being chased by a great monster. There's a precipice ahead and you can't turn back. and you wish you would wake up and find yourself safe in bed. Except that this was no dream. It was a real thing. And there was no easy escape, like waking up. There just wasn't any escape at all. Hanan, if that was his name, had discovered a peculiar white spot on his body. He had rubbed at it frantically, but it wouldn't go away. And days later, it was still there growing larger. And it kept on growing. He tried to forget it, but he could think of nothing else. He tried to hope it would get better, but then panic seized him. He knew it would never get better. He tried to hide it beneath his clothes. But one day, someone saw it. A terrible fuss was made, and Hanan was driven from home and told he must never come back. From that time on, he was a cursed man. How much time passed, I do not know. If it was very long, the spots and the swellings must have grown larger. Perhaps his eyelids fell off and some of his fingers and toes wasted away. For Hanan had leprosy. Presently, in his lonely wanderings, he found 9 other lepers and joined them. An ugly, forlorn, hopeless group. Then one day, they heard good news. There was a man called Jesus who was healing sick people. It had even been reported that he had cured a leper. Perhaps. The 10 men rushed to find him. I should really say they hobbled. For with stiff knees and swollen feet and toes missing, it was slow going. But they pressed on and finally fell down at Jesus' feet. Jesus told them to go and show themselves to the priests, who would have to give them a certificate saying they were well. They got up and staggered away. At first nothing happened. Then I can hear one of them saying, "Look, my feet are better." And another, "My nose, it's come back." So happy they jumped for joy, then ran on to find the priests. But suddenly Hanan stopped, turned around and ran back. Finding Jesus again, he fell down at his feet once more and thanked him again and again for healing him. Jesus looked kindly at him, then glanced around. Where were the others? Disappointed, he asked sadly. Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? They hadn't bothered to come. Only one of the 10 had returned to say, "Thank you." Are you like Hanan or one of the 9? All your life Jesus has given you food and clothes and home and friends. Let's be like the one who came back. Jesus will appreciate it.
Thank you, Sarah, for sharing a nice story.
You are listening to The Voice of Hope from Pune, India. For more information on our program, you could contact us on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
Before you hear God's word, stay tuned for this song, "God is So Wonderful," by Jody and Loni Melashenko.
God is so wonderful, I can't explain, but I can say, glory, hallelujah, praise His holy name. Oh, God is so wonderful, I can't explain, but I can say, saved me. It's wonderful that He forgave me. It's wonderful, wonderful, so very wonderful, wonderful that He is mine. I cast on Him my every burden, lay at His feet my every care. It's wonderful, so very wonderful, wonderful that He is mine. God is so wonderful,
explain, but I can say, glory, hallelujah. Praise His holy name. Wonderful.
Our Bible theme today is Walking with God, and today we are glad to have John Daniel with us to share God's Word.
It's an enormous privilege once again to be here on the Adventist World Radio, and the message entitles Walking with God. And the scriptures chosen is Genesis 5:24, and it reads, "And Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him." The Bible says Enoch walked with God. Who was Enoch? The Bible tells us that he was the son of Jared, the father of Methuselah, and the seventh in the descendant from Adam in the line of Seth. The Bible says he lived 365 years. The brief record for his life is written in the words, "Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him." The words "walked with God" denote a devout life lived in close communion with God. The words "and he was not" are explained by faith. Enoch was translated that he should not see death and was not found, because God had translated him. For before his death, he was not found, and he had his testimony that he pleased God. The words "lived, begat, and died" in Genesis reveal how brief and uniform are our lives. Enoch was a man who walked with God. Using the story of Enoch's life, I want to share with you some pertinent points concerning walking with God. The companion of walking with God. The companion for life's walk is a divine companion. Paul said, "And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. As God hath said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people." The agnostic and the skeptic ask, "Where is God?" The Christian, like Enoch, is quietly walking with this divine companion. The companion for life's walk is a close companion. The Bible says, "A friend loveth at all times," and God is a companion who is near at all times. He makes his abode in the Christian and walks with him or her always. The companion for life's walk is a faithful companion. We can trust him, for he is faithful and just. He does not desert us before our foes. He wants to be with us and is preparing a place for us. The demands of walking with God. Walking with God demands entire surrender. The name Enoch means dedicated, one yielded up to God, to be conformed to God's mind and will. Walking with God demands surrender to God's will. Paul indicated this surrender when he wrote, "And be found in him, not having mine own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith." Walking with God demands unbroken fellowship. As Enoch walked with God, he had fellowship with God. They were in two perfect agreements. Amos said, "Can two walk together except they be agreed?" Enoch had good company for the road of life. Walking with God makes the trip of life enjoyable. Walking with God demands continual progress. Our knowledge of God must continually be growing, because the chariot wheel of life never stands still. Each day is a new journey, for we have not passed this way before we journey toward a new country, the upward way, the promised land. Also, walking with God demands complete separation. Walking with God prohibits indulgence in the sinful pleasure of the world. God is light, and those who walk with Him do not walk in darkness. Paul said, "Let your affections on things above, not on things on earth." The book of Leviticus says, "Sanctify yourself, therefore, and be ye holy, for I am the Lord your God." Walking with God demands suffering. Those who walk with God suffer the criticism and hatred of the world. They suffer as good soldiers of Jesus Christ. The manner of walking with God. Walking with God means walking by faith. We receive Christ through faith. Paul said, "For ye are the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus, and for by grace ye are saved through faith. And that not of ourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." We walk by faith in happiness, sorrow, turmoil, and death. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Walking with God means not walking in a hypocritical way. We do not walk with faces disfigured, but transfigured, not conformed to the rites of humanity, but transformed by the power of God. We do not walk with a pious face, but with pious life. We do not walk with ears opened to idle tales or gossip, but to the voice of God. Walking with God means walking in truth. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." John the Apostle said, "For I rejoiced greatly when the brethren came and testified of the truth that is in thee, even as thou walkest in the truth." Yes, dear friends, walking with God means a spiritual walk. Paul said, "This is I, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. If we live in the Spirit, let us walk also in the Spirit." The privileges of walking with God. Walking with God assures us of the forgiveness of our sins. John the Apostle said, "If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." The greatest of all feelings is the joy of walking with God on the highway of life and knowing that you are forgiven and cleansed. Walking with God assures us of strength day by day. The Lord had promised to be with us always. Paul said, "Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, that by me the preaching might be fully known, that all the Gentiles might hear, and I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work, and will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory for ever and ever. Amen." As we walk with Him, He does give us strength when it is needed. Walking with God assures us of comfort for life's sorrow. Enoch did not die, but I'm sure he had sorrows along life's journey. Who doesn't? Many passages of God's word assure us of comfort for life's sorrows. God is with us, and He speaks to us. Walking with God assures us of happiness for life's journey. Walking with God is happiness, true happiness. Dear listeners, Paul knew about that Jesus, even in prison, wrote to the Philippians urging them to rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. Dear believers, begin today your walk with the Lord Jesus Christ, and He will go with you each step of the way. Amen.
Thank you, John Daniel, for sharing God's word.
You are listening to the Voice of Hope from Pune, India.
We trust you've been enjoying our program. The Bible says, while Jesus was walking with His disciples, He turned and asked His disciples, "What do you seek?" we find that they were wanting to fellowship with him. They wanted to walk with Jesus. Friends, I wonder how often we miss an opportunity to spend time with Jesus because we've been seeking something other than his presence. I know from experience that the more time I spend with Jesus, the less I desire I have for a lot of things that once seemed very important for me.
Jesus longs for our fellowship even more than we long for his.
That brings us to the end of our program. Should you want to know more on God's Word, you are invited to write to us on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
That is Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
You could also email us on amc3@vsnl.com.
That's amc3@vsnl.com. I'm Sharad.
And I'm Anita, signing out from Adventist World Radio. Do join us again.
Until then, may you fellowship with God through prayer and study of God's Word. Goodbye, and God bless you.